Jakarta, one of the most densely populated cities on the planet, and also the capital of Indonesia, the Asian giant with 250 million people. It's our giant neighbour to the north, and yet it's a country that many Australians know absolutely nothing about. That's a real shame, because Jakarta is such a vibrant, frenetic city. There are always hundreds of people around, and when you're here in the city, many of those people are going to be getting into a Bluebird taxi. It's now the largest taxi company in Jakarta, and also diversifying into a transport and logistics company. The woman behind the company now famously still drives a taxi herself occasionally, just so she can get in touch with what's happening on the shop floor. Noni Purnomo is the president director of Bluebird Group. Hello, Noni.
Hi, it's good to see you.
So, Bluebird Taxis, it's a huge taxi company, and it's turned taking a taxi around Jakarta from a calculated gamble into a safe bet. But how have you achieved this?
I think we started to build the brand based on trust since the very beginning. So we started on the 1st of May 1972. And the first thing, the founder was my late grandmother. So that was very unique on that time, a woman founded a taxi company. So since the very beginning, we really focused on giving the best quality service. So the first thing that we focus on is the integrity of the drivers. And so each driver have to go through really thorough selections of including their behavior, their aggressiveness, being checked by psychologists, and also their driving technique to ensure the comfort of the during the transport, the whole experience of the passengers. So we really base on those values, first integrity and hard work, discipline, and also care for others. So I think throughout the year, because of the consistency of building those values, then we got the trusted brand in Indonesia.
And you also briefly touched on it there, that the booming population in Jakarta includes a very large section now of the middle class, something that you wouldn't have seen maybe 20 or 30 years or so ago. Many of those have moved from taking a Bluebird taxi into a Silverbird taxi and some of the other parts of your brand. Why have you decided to diversify, though, into Silverbirds, into limousines?
I think you touch upon it perfectly, yeah? Because we recognize the different needs of different segments of our passengers. So the Bluebird regular taxi cater for the regular users and more of a mass. The executive Silverbird taxi caters for the passengers who need more comfort, whether it's the leg room or the type of car, because we're using a luxurious type of sedan and also van. Also, the other difference is the Silverbird executive taxi can wait for you. So while the regular taxi, they just normally just drop, pick and drop. So there's a lot of business usage for that. So we try to cater to different needs of our passengers. And it's not just Bluebird for regular taxi. We have Silverbird executive taxi. We also have a Goldenbird car rental and limousine service, or chauffeur driven service, which cater mostly for B2B, because a lot of companies, they need to have operational cars, and they don't want to get the headache of running the transportation themselves, because they have to take care of the drivers, they have to take care of the car maintenance. So they outsource it to us. So Goldenbird is catering for that, and also for retail, just like this new online transportation company is arising in the world. So.
And those, of course, the online transport companies would be companies like Uber or Gojek. Are they a threat to your operation?
I think we've been around for almost 45 years, and in different era we face different type of competitions. So we see this as a new type of competitions. So a lot of people see them as the disruptors of technology, disrupting the industry. But we see it as an opportunity as well. We do need technology to help us enhancing our business, whether it's to make our operation more efficient, or to enhance the customer experience itself. So we don't see them as a competitor in the technology side, but we learn from them on how to be able to engage with more customer, and how can we adapt to the new technologies so that the distribution of our vehicles are more efficient, because that way it's better for our company. And so that's where we learn. And about the easiness of payment, because we rely still up to today a lot on cash payment. But with the new technology, we can also give options to the customers. So yes, we see them as competitors, but we also see the new digital era as an opportunity.
Yeah, and certainly Uber and Gojek as well in Jakarta, they've got very strong branding. People around the world can recognize them as a company. You've got very strong branding in terms of the Bluebird companies, but how important is it? How important is it that somebody down the street can immediately recognize a Bluebird taxi and will want to get in it?
I think it is very important for us to be the first choice of the customer. And I think the distinctive difference also, because our taxis have an identity. So you can straight away spot that this is a Bluebird taxi. Unlike the online taxi companies, they normally don't have a uniform image. But the distinctive difference by choosing our services is because the customer can have that trust, that they know that they're going into a car or a taxi that have the same quality, whether it's the driver or the vehicle itself. Because we do maintain our vehicle very, very well. We have our own service station and maintenance depot, because the difference operation-wise, the difference between Bluebird and other taxi companies worldwide is because we own and operate the taxis, and we don't just lease it to our drivers. So therefore, every day the car would come back to our depots to be maintained, whether it's just to be washed or to be maintained if there is any scratches or things. So the next day, when the car comes out to the road, it looks perfect again.
And yet, if I was an accountant, I'd be going, it's much cheaper to outsource these facilities rather than doing it in-house. How do you balance the desire for quality to get the best possible quality for the customer so you have a reliable brand, with at the same point, just going for the cheapest possible option?
Yeah, we did that calculations. Number one, because of our size also, because of the economic of scale, then it makes more sense for us to do it in-house. But most importantly, when we look into that issue, that we operate in the different hours than the normal service station operates. Because most of our cars comes out early in the morning, around 4, 5 a.m., and they will come back in the evening. So we do the maintenance in the evening. So most of the cars are being maintained in the evenings. So for that reason, then it's better for us to do it in-house. And also with our fleet and with our mechanics, you know, and we have one basically type of vehicle for each category. So our mechanics are really the expert on that model. So with times, it becomes more economical to do it internally.
So you've expanded obviously into Silverbird and then quite a number of other brands. You're also expanding geographically, because the company started off just in Jakarta, but now is well known throughout most of Indonesia. Why have you decided to go to many other cities? And surely this must be a huge logistical problem in terms of keeping an eye on what all the parts of the company are doing.
We expanded our operations so that we can cover the whole Indonesia to cater to the needs of the passengers also. Even for expats, when they come to Indonesia, in the old days they only have business in Jakarta. Now they have businesses throughout Indonesia, and they want to use the same brand that they recognize, and it's easier for them to to consolidate the payment, the billings and things. So it's so much easier and it's more reliable. It's a brand that they know. So we grow together with the expansion of the businesses also in Indonesia. And to control, I think we rely on technology again, because each of our cars are installed with GPS so that we can monitor the location of each car. And then we installed with a call center, with the monitoring system. We use SAP as a backbone, so we have a national control of every single spare parts being changed, because it's a cost efficiency also for us. So we use technology to monitor closely. But most important of all are the people. The way we select the people is the best control we have, because we only want to recruit the right people to work in our organization.
And you've been recognized by Forbes magazine as well. They recognized you as a businesswoman in Asia. But how do you juggle all the demands of running a very big company with being a wife, a mother, everything else that you've got in your life?
I think quality time. I think quality is more important than quantity. I think it's about how you schedule your time to make yourself feel comfortable. It's not without challenge. I used to be more like a perfectionist, that I want to juggle all three balls that you mentioned up in the air all the time. I mean, even a perfect juggler cannot do that. So then I realized that as a human being, we have to recognize our own strength and weaknesses. So now that each at different time, I recognize which ball that I need to put down in order to keep one in the air, or at least two in the air. So that way I manage the time with my kids, family time, and also work time, including imposing certain rules. As simple as I told my kids, unless it's emergency during working hours, you cannot contact me. But they know if there is an emergency, they can contact me anytime, and they have a special number for me. So I have two phones.
And yet, while you're prioritizing your task during the day and at the same time trying to ensure you've got some family time in the evening, for Bluebird, you've almost made it more complicated by diversifying into being a logistics company, a transport company, all these other things. Firstly, why? And then what are you going to do in the future? Do you have global ambitions?
Yeah, I think the reason why we expand is because we want to take part in the development of Indonesia as a nation. And what we're good at is to give reliable transportation services. So we extend that to supporting the infrastructure, because as you mentioned, we still have a lot of opportunity and challenges in the infrastructures. So that's why we not only that we are now servicing the passenger transport, but we're also giving service to the goods transport, which is the logistics. As we all know, I think logistic costs in Indonesia is still extremely high. It's 27% of cost of goods sold, extremely high. So we want to take part into that, because I know there is a huge challenge with Indonesia because we have a lot of islands, so it is more expensive. But I am sure with our business efficiency, with the operational excellence that we experience from the passenger transport, we can also adapt it into this logistics services company. And on top of that, we also have a trading company for heavy equipments, which is part of supporting the building of the infrastructure in Indonesia.
And in doing so, of course, hopefully you can improve Jakarta's roads so your taxis can get around more efficiently.
Yes.
It's very much that joined up business thinking. I wish you the best of luck, Noni.
Thank you.
It's been great talking to you.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you.